How can smart people, how can they believe in the talking snake and people lived to 900 years old and the virgin birth? And, you know, that's my question.
Now look, if I told you if you kissed a frog, it would turn to a prince. How many of you ladies got your husband by kissing a frog? Come on now, let me see. Only two, okay. Doesn't happen very often. But in the textbooks it does. Yes, boys and girls, we started like an amoeba. And we slowly evolved to a frog. There he is, Grandpa. And then very slowly evolved to a prince. It's the same fairy tale. Frog turns to prince. But see, instead of a kiss, no, they got a new magic ingredient. If the frog turns to the prince quickly, we all know it's a fairy tale. But if the frog turns to the prince slowly, that's modern science. It's the same fairy tale, folks, but they have a new magic ingredient. The new ingredient to turn the frog to a prince is billions and billions of years. How many have ever heard that expression before? Billions of years ago. It's on TV. It's on Carol Sagan's show, Cosmos. Billions and billions of years ago. It's in the magazines. It's in National Pornographic. I'm Geographic. No. Billions and billions of years ago. Here's a fourth grade textbook. Millions of years ago. Now, kids, listen. If anybody ever says, millions of years ago, just say, excuse me, were you there? They'll say, well, no, of course I wasn't there. And you can say, now, teacher, do you know the Earth is millions of years old? I mean, is this really part of science? Is this something we can observe and study and test and demonstrate in the laboratory? Or is this just something people believe? They're going to say, well, everybody believes the Earth is millions of years old. No, they don't. Most Americans think the Earth is less than 10,000 years old and God made it. Only 4% are atheistic. I think that 4% ought to go start themselves a private school and teach evolution to anybody that wants to pay and come learn it. And they ought to get it out of our public schools. That's my unbiased opinion. Yeah.
But you must be jumping up and down, because this is what you've devoted your life to, evolutionary biology, and here they found this new species from 4.4 million years ago. How is that possible if the Earth is only 10,000 years old?
It's called Ardipithecus ramidus. It's about 4.4 billion years ago, and as you
million.
Say... Billion. What did I say?
Billion. It's...
Million.
It's 4.4 for a million or billion?
Million.
Million, yes.
Isn't that what I said?
I hope so. I was testing
okay.
It's interesting to see the inflation of the age of the Earth. See, in 1770, they said the Earth was 70,000 years old. By 1902, it was 2 billion years old. 1969, it was 3.5 billion years old. Today, it's 4.6. Did you know the Earth is getting older at the rate of 21 million years per year? That's 40 years per minute. Okay, it's aging rapidly, folks. Anyway.
4.4 million years, which is a bit older than Lucy, about 3 million years.
Right.
Which was Lucy is a slightly more complete fossil. It's kind of getting on towards the common ancestor with chimpanzees, which lived about 6 or 7 million years ago. So it's not the common ancestor. It's too recent for that.
But the Darwin deniers always say we don't have enough intermediary species in the fossil history. Does this help that?
Of course. I mean, that was true when Darwin himself lived. There weren't any. And they still say, show us the missing link. Where's your missing link? And there are quite a few of them now. And
right.
Ardipithecus is just one of a great troop of them which have been found.
So explain this to me. I mean, we all evolved, and we all have the same brain, basically, now. So how can some of us believe in this, not believe in? We shouldn't say that, because we don't believe in this. It's the truth. We studied this, and it's scientific evidence. But how can some people feel this way about it? And then there are at least half of America who thinks the world was created by a man in a cloud in 6 days who then needed to rest. I love that. He's so powerful, he can create the universe, but then he's pooped. I mean, how can we have the same brain?
I'm sorry to say we don't have the same brain.
Since if evolution's true, why are there still monkeys? Should it be taught at all?
But it should never be presented to children in a science class in a public school as science, because it isn't. It's a religious belief.
Deepak, is it a faith issue?
It is a faith issue. I totally agree with her. I think we have to look at the scientific evidence, which says that the universe is 13.8 billion years old. The planet is only 3.8 billion. Human beings have been around for 200,000 years in the form that we know them. But, you know, hominids have been around for a long time. Now, having said that, there is evidence in science that there is creativity in the universe, that consciousness may not be an emergent property, that physical matter may be an emergent property, that consciousness conceives and governs and constructs and actually becomes what we call mind and then body and the physical universe.
Yeah, well, I think intelligent design is the only possible scientific position to hold, because we have intelligence in the universe. It has to come from intelligence. Because we have complexity, it has to come from complexity. The silver bullet, Larry, is DNA. Before an understanding of DNA, there was a lot of confusion and a lot of belief in evolution. It was like the emperor's new clothes. It was really naked, but thought it was dressed up. DNA has, I think, spelled the end of traditional naturalistic evolution, which essentially says complexity comes out of simplicity. It can't happen. The silver bullet is not a single example of reproduction leading to an increased amount of genetic material necessary to produce a more complex organism has ever happened.
As someone religion, though, you can't prove Adam and Eve, can you?
Oh, I don't think you can prove Adam and Eve, except that you know somebody was there to begin.
You believe it.
Yeah, well, we're talking about two different things. Intelligent design is the only rational way to view the universe. Somebody intelligent made it. Religion and who that intelligence is.
Does it ponder you who made the intelligence? Who created the creator?
I accept the Bible as the source, the authoritative source that tells me it was God, and something or someone has to be eternal. And the Bible says it is God who is the eternal one.
See, when he says that, he's denying all of biology, all of anthropology, all of geology, all of astronomy, all of cosmology, all of evolution. It's all of physics, all of chemistry, and everything that we know, that we have learned. Now, I do agree with Dr. Richards, who says that there is evidence that we need to understand Darwin's theory a little bit better, or, you know, it's a little 150 years old.
Is it possible for an ape-like creature to become a human? Well, they tell the kids that the human and the chimpanzee are related. The human and the orangutan are 96% similar. That proves a common ancestor 15 million years ago. Well, this is baloney. Barney Maddox, the leading genome researcher, he said, the genetic difference between human and his nearest relative, the chimpanzee, is at least 1.6%. That doesn't sound like much, but calculated out, that's a gap of 48 million nucleotides, and a change of only 3 nucleotides is fatal to an organ animal. There is no possibility of change. Kids, when they tell you that you have proof for evolution because the human and the chimpanzee are similar DNA, they're confused or they're lying to you.
At our museum in New York, the American Museum of Natural History, they come to the Big Bang exhibit. And sometimes I don't feel like having that conversation. I say, why don't you go to our hall of human biology first, and then come to us. And that's where we have sort of monkeys holding hands with people in skeleton forms. And then they never make it back to the Big Bang. They're gone forever. Why don't you go to our hall of human biology first, and then come to us? And that's where we have sort of monkeys holding hands with people in skeleton form, and then they never make it back to the Big Bang. They're gone forever.
are modern animals just as we are. They are modern animals just as we are. They are our cousins. They are not our ancestors.
You would have to have help to be that dumb. You could not do it on your own. You'd have to have years of training and conditioning to believe such a silly idea.
Sure, let's hear your new theory, Kent Hovind. What is the theory you have to offer to replace the scientific theory of evolution? The answer is no theory. There is no theory.
No, I've got a very
the reason it's not taught, all she would do is say, God did it. Okay.
Get a computer program, any computer program, make a copy of it onto a disk, then copy it to another disk, then copy it to another disk. Do that 1,000 times. See if it'll still run. That's the DNA code that we have, folks. It's incredibly complex. I think the only reason anybody would say this happened by chance and there was no designer is because they don't want to find that designer. The atheist can't find God for the same reason a thief can't find a policeman.
At this moment, God commands all men to repent and believe that today is the day of salvation, that you are to flee from the wrath to come, to flee from the law of Moses that condemns you into the city of refuge, who is Jesus Christ our Lord. Run to Him. Repentance is simply giving up, to stop fighting against God and to stop attempting to gain your own salvation through your own works, to literally give up and fall upon Christ. That is salvation. So that you say, nothing in my hands I bring, simply to the cross I cling. And when that seed grows in you to the point where you know that you're standing before God is 100 absolutely percent based and founded upon the perfect work and merit of Jesus Christ, then you stand before Him with confidence, knowing that all your sins have been atoned for and that you are righteous in Christ. Come to Him.
If you're not sure you're going to heaven, why don't you ask the Lord to save you? It really is that simple. Just pray with me right now. Just say, Dear Lord Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner. I've broken your laws, and I'm sorry. Lord, I believe you died for me. Would you please forgive my sin and save me right now? Amen. Well, friend, if you just ask the Lord to come in your heart and save you, the Bible says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. You've got God's promise. You're going to heaven. What you need to do is write this date and the time down in the front of your Bible someplace, because the devil will certainly try to make you doubt that you're going to heaven. And you need to start reading your Bible. You need to start going to a good church that believes the Bible and start learning what this book says and read God's Word. As a newborn baby, you need to grow by desiring the sincere milk of the Word. The more you read this book, the more you grow to be a good Christian. Call us and let us know, or write us a letter. We'd be glad to rejoice with you and give you some information to help you grow closer to the Lord in your new life. If we can be any help, don't hesitate to call. Thank you so much.